This is the first weekend you can buy beer and wine in Benton County, and some people worry underage drinkers will try to pull a fast one. 4029's Ugoti Iloka shows us how one store is making sure buyers are following the rules. It's new tonight.
Going wet has its pros and cons. One possible problem, an increase in underage drinking. With fake IDs so easy to access, 4029 went to find out if convenience stores are ready to take on this challenge. Casey's general store manager, Sharon Moore, says her store is ready.
Well, we trained with on the computer. We have a program that they have to go through training to answer questions to see if how, you know, they know whether they're eligible to buy the beer.
She tells me employees are also trained to scan the barcode that indicates if a person is old enough to drink.
Now, this is a scanner that Sharon uses to detect fake IDs.
The scanner isn't the only way employees can spot fake IDs. Benton County Sheriff Kelly Craddock tells us two red flags are poor quality out-of-state photos and IDs that don't have holograms.
You know, in the past, what we've done is we've put on Halloween masks and make IDs that are really, truly identification cards, but all they're doing then, the clerk is looking at the date of birth and handing it back instead of making sure they're looking at the picture along with the date of birth.
Casey says if police decide to pay them an undercover visit, they'll be ready. Ugoti Iloka, 4029 News.
The Benton County Sheriff's Department tells us any local businesses selling alcohol can contact them if they want to learn how to spot fake IDs.